What we are going to study in Unit 1, that is nothing but the design strategies. So the content is, the first content is the role of algorithms in computing. The second one is we are going to study the sorting algorithms. Third one, we are going to see the working of all those algorithms. Then there are several functions referred as a growth of functions. Then divide and conquer algorithm. And finally, we are going to study the probabilistic analysis and randomized algorithm. This is the content for Unit 1, and we are going to study one by one. Before that, let us understand what is the meaning of this content. So I will use one pen. Okay, so let us understand the use of role of algorithm in computing. Okay, so what is the purpose of algorithms? Algorithms are used to carry some work in predefined manner. Means it can be, suppose if you want to add 5 numbers. Okay, if you want to add 5 numbers, what you will do, you will input first number and we will store it to answer. Then you will take second number and you will add that number to answer. You will take third number, you will add that number to answer. You will take fourth number, you will add that number to answer, and also you will take the fifth number and you will add that number into the answer. So these are number of steps, or these are steps that you are going to follow to add 5 numbers. So the step one will be initialize answer is equal to 0. Then the step two will be take first number and store it into the answer or add with answer. So it should be like this. Answer is equal to answer plus number. So this will be your logic behind adding 5 numbers. And there should be loop while I is less than number of numbers. Or I is less than or equal to number of numbers. Means suppose if there are 5 numbers, you will initialize I to 1. Okay, if you are initializing I to 1, then it should be equal to. If you are initializing I to 0, it should be less than. So if there are 5 numbers, so loop will run for 5 times. If there are 6 numbers, the loop will run for 6 times. So you are going to organize your actual work in some set of lines, and it is defined as a algorithm. Okay, now what is the role of algorithm in computing? Actually, every computing task is made with the algorithm. You can't proceed without touching this sub word, because algorithm is exactly equal to computing. If you want to add some numbers, if you want to subtract some numbers, if you want to work with some web services, if you want to work with some server applications, if you want to work with some desktop applications or some standalone application, the algorithm is the necessary thing. Okay, so this is what the important aspect in computing. So this line is a very important line, and the role for this role of algorithm in computing should be a very highly expected. Okay, now we are going to study the role of algorithms, but there should be some examples over those algorithms. So we are going to study we are going to take the examples of sorting algorithms. Okay, there are n number of sorting algorithms, like the bubble sorting is over there, insertion sorting is over there, then merge sorting is also there. So you are going to study all the kind of algorithms. Okay, and you are going to study all the kind of algorithms in this unit. Now there is a difference between the UG and PG. So I'm drawing a boundary over here. This is the concept that you have learned in UG. Okay, these are the concepts that you have learned in UG. The role of algorithms, the definition of algorithms, then the examples of algorithms. Then you might have learned a different thing like this, different algorithms like the sorting algorithms. various kind of examples that you have studied over there. We are going to do the same thing as we were doing in UG. I think it should be in somewhere in FY or SY, right? But now you are in PG, so there should be some PG work also there. So you are going to see the working of these algorithms. Now, what is the meaning of working? Suppose if I want to deal with some sorting of numbers, so let us take the numbers 1, 5, 6, 8, and let it be 2. Okay, I want to sort these numbers. So the sorting will be like this: 1, 2, 5, 6, 8. This is the kind of working. This is the one type of working. You have to analyze that algorithm. Now, what is the meaning of analysis? What is the meaning of analyzing the algorithm? That we are going to study, or that we are going to look in Unit 1. So let us understand in detail. Suppose if you are dealing with some UG kind of work, then if I have asked you to sort the numbers, you must have used any one algorithm like insertion sort, or say bubble sort, or say merge sort, and you will sort this number accordingly. Okay, now while sorting this number, just listen carefully. While sorting this number, you have spent some time over sorting. So this is the first parameter to analyze. The first parameter to analyze is the time. The second parameter is also there. Now let us go back to this kind of example. Here, what I am doing, answer is equal to answer plus number. Means I'm going to store three variables over here. The first one answer, the second one number, and the third one is I. Means it is used for the iterations. Okay. So in other words, what I'm going to use, second parameter, that is space. Okay. So I'm going to work with the space also, because I'm going to reserve the memory for these three variables. Okay, if I'm going to sort the, suppose if I want to use the five numbers, okay, if I'm not going to use that particular loop, what I will do, I will use answer one, answer two, or I will use number one, number two, number three, number four, number five. So what will happen? I'm going to use the five variables with the answer along with the I. So there will be some seven variables. Okay, but if I'm going to use the loop, I can use a single number variable to store that particular number, and I can input those numbers accordingly. So here I'm going to use the second parameter, that is space. This is space. Okay, now whenever I'm dealing with algorithm, and whenever I'm computing that algorithm with respect to time, it is referred as a time complexity. I repeat, whenever I'm dealing with some algorithm and whenever I'm calculating its performance with time, it is referred as a time complexity. But whenever I'm dealing with a space, or whenever I'm dealing with a memory, it is referred as a space complexity. So we have two types of complexity. The first one is a time complexity, and the second one is a space complexity. So in this case of working, we are going to calculate the time complexity as well as the space complexity. Also, while calculating the time complexity and while calculating the space complexity, we have to refer three kind of cases. Okay, the first case is the best case, the second case is the worst case, and the third case is the average case. So I will explain those cases whenever we will deal with that particular sorting algorithm, so you will get the better understanding. But as of now, let just remind one thing, that you are supposed to do, or you have supposed to learn the working of algorithm, and while working with all these algorithm, you have to calculate the space complexity as well as time complexity. Then there will be a growth of functions, so it will define the way, and it will define the way of working of the algorithm. Then divide and conquer algorithm, and this is the probabilistic analysis and the randomized algorithm that we are going to study. So these are six concepts that we are going to study in Unit 1. Okay, so let us start. So let us define the definition for algorithm. So informally, okay, I'm using the word informally, the algorithm is any well-defined computational procedure that takes some value or set of values and input and produces some value or set of values as output. And the book definition is the algorithm is there's a sequence of computational steps that transform the input into output. So I can draw a diagram like this. This is your steps of instructions. These are your steps of instructions. This is your input and this is your output. Okay, and this box is referred as algorithm. Okay, so we can say that there are these are the number of steps which are going to convert your input into output. Okay, any query in this definition? If you have any query, please ask. Okay. So let us proceed. How we are going to see the algorithm, or how we are going to study the algorithms. The basic thing we are going to study is nothing but the data structures. Then there is a concept called as the hard problems. Now, what is the meaning of those hard problems? Actually, the meaning is quite simple. Suppose if there are some problems which can be solved in a particular manner or in particular way, it is referred as a soft problems. And there are some problems which can be referred, which cannot be solved in a particular way or in particular time interval, it is referred as a hard problem. Means, for example, suppose if you are sending an email to a person, okay, it is referred as a soft problem, because as soon as you are sending, that particular receiver will receive the message. Then parallelism is a very known structure that you must be knowing, because you can perform multiple actions in parallel way or at the same time. Means, suppose if I want to print something, I will do simultaneously. If I want to write something, I will do simultaneously. So it is going to save the time. And from all these parameters, we are going to measure the efficiency. Okay. Now let us understand the sorting problem. So let us work with the sorting problem. Okay. See, today we are dealing with the first lecture. So I'm not going to bombard you with all the problems. So as this is the first lecture, we will do a single sorting algorithm, that is the insertion sort algorithm. We'll solve the problems and later on we will stop over here. Okay. So before that, let us understand the definition of sorting problem. Now, what is the meaning of sorting problem? Suppose you are given with several numbers. So A1, A2, up to AN. If you are able to permute those number or reorder those number in A1, A2, up to AN, such that A1 dash is less than or equal to A2 dash is less than or equal to up to AN dash. So this is defined as a sorting problem. Now let me explain what is the meaning of this problem. So let us consider I have five numbers, A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5. So these are referred as sequence of five numbers. These are referred as a sequence of five numbers. And now I want to permute these numbers, or I want to reorder these numbers either in ascending order or in descending order. So I want to permute this number either in ascending order or descending order. So how can I perform these things? How can I say these numbers are in ascending order? So these numbers are in ascending order if A1 is less than or equal to A2, is less than or equal to A3, is less than or equal to A4, and is less than or equal to A5. So I can say A1, A2, A3, A4, A5 are in ascending order. Now, how can I say the numbers are in descending order? If A1 is less than or equal to A2, is less than or equal to A3, is less than or equal to A4, sorry, it's a greater than or equal to, the sign is, I will repeat again. So A1 is greater than or equal to A2, greater than or equal to A3, and greater than or equal to A4, and greater than or equal to A5, then it is referred, we will call it as the numbers are in descending order. So let us go with one example. 2, 4, 5, 7, or say 10. This is the first case, and in second case, 10, 7, 5, 4, 2. Okay, now in first case, we can say that the number are in ascending order, while in second case, we can say that the numbers are in descending order, because in first example, 2 is less than 4, less than 5, less than 7, and less than 10. Similarly, while considering the descending orders, 10 is greater than 7, is greater than 5, is greater than 4, and is greater than 2. Now, don't confuse with these numbers. Actually, see here, we are saying that these are the sequence of numbers, but you have to refer them as a positions. You have to refer them as a positions. So this will be A1, this will be A2, this will be A3, this will be A4, and this will be A5. Okay, these are the positions. These are actually not the numbers, but these are the positions. So this is the A1, A2, A3, A4, A5. Similarly, here, this number is not going to be A1, but this number is going to be A1. A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5. Okay, now, see here, we can say that the A1 is changing. Therefore, we have A1, but here we have A1 dash. Okay, as the A1 is changing, so here we have A1, whereas here we have A1 dash. Okay, similarly, these numbers can be interchanged. Means, let us take one more example, like 5, 3, 4, 2, 8. So this will be A1. This will be A2, this will be A3, this will be A4, and this will be A5. Okay, now let us arrange those numbers. It will be like this in ascending order. So it will be like this. 2, 3, 4, 5, and 8. So now this number will be A1 dash, this will be A2 dash, this will be A3 dash, this will be A4 dash, and this will be A5 dash. Okay, so you can say like this, if you want to compare the numbers, it will be like this. As of we have considered this as a A4, we have considered this as a A3, we have considered, sorry, A2, we have considered this as a A3, we have considered this as a A1, and this is the A5. So A1 dash is equal to A4, A2 dash is equal to A2, A3 dash is equal to A3, A4 dash is equal to A1, and A5 dash is equal to A3. So this number is going to change, therefore you have indicated that number with dash. Okay, there is nothing logic behind that. As of number of change, you're going to change the numbers. Okay, and these are the actual positions. These are the positions. So this is the definition of the sorting problems, a book definition. A sequence of n numbers a1 a2 up to an, a permutation or reordering of a1 a2 an as a1 dash is less than or equal to a2 dash is less than or equal to something is less than an dash, then it is defined as a sorting problem. Now before sorting, how you are going to represent the data? Usually the numbers to be sorted are the part of collection of data. It is called as a record. A record contains a key which is the value to be stored. So note that key here, key and other data. Other data is used, is referred as a metadata, and you're going to compare that data, or you're going to use that data to connect this tuple with another tuple. And that is a simple concept that you're going to work. There is nothing, a big logic behind it. A simple logical concept is over there. Now note that when the keys must be rearranged, the data associated with the keys must also rearrange. So it is definitely time consuming. So you are going to calculate the time complexity. And the second one, the pointers can be used instead. So it is a space consuming. So it is referred as a space complexity. So this data, so this tuple is going to decide your time as well as space. Okay, and these two things are going to decide the performance of your algorithm. Now, why to study algorithms? What is the use of those algorithms? So there are a variety of situations that we can encounter. Like if you want to order something, if you want to use some keys distinct, or if there is a large number of state, and if you want to make the actual searching, because if there are some tuples, there are suppose 1 lakh tuples are there, and if you sorted those tuples according to alphabetical manner or some other different manner, then you are able to search that particular thing quite easily. Therefore the sorting is a very important thing in all aspects. Now there are some more definitions of the sortings are there, like the internal sort, the external sort, and in place sort. Okay, we are not going to deal with that particular definitions because we don't have this into this labels. So let us concentrate on our first topic, that is the insertion sort. So this is a very important topic that you're going to study. Insertion sort. Insertion sort is one of the sorting technique that you're going to use for sorting a particular thing. Okay, so how you're going to deal with these things? So just consider that you're playing some cards with some cards. Okay, and if you start with some empty left hand, and suppose if the cards are facing down the table, you're going to pick up those cards, and later on you're going to arrange those cards according to some particular manner. Okay, what you do, you just remove the card from the inappropriate place, and you place that cart into the appropriate place. This is the concept that you are going to use the insertion sort. What you are going to see, you are going to pick the numbers which is in inappropriate place. So I will give one example. Suppose these are the numbers 5, 4, 2, 8, and 10. Okay, now I will focus all these numbers. So I will concentrate on 4. I will feel that the 4 is not in the appropriate place. Why so? Because if you want to arrange the numbers in ascending order, then 4 should be before 5. So this is in inappropriate place. So what I will do, I will insert that number. I will pick that number from inappropriate place and I will place that number into the appropriate place. So now my 4 will go over here. And similarly, as 4 is going to occupy the position of 5 will be replaced over here. So now the numbers will be like this: 4, 5, 2, 8, 10. Okay, now I will go with the 2 and I will found that the 2 is not in proper place. So what I will do, I will pick up that 2 and I will put 2 into the place of 4. So this is 2. So as 2 is going to take the place of 4, so 4 will be in place of 5 and 5 will be in place of 2. Okay, so the numbers will be like this: 2, 4, 5, 8, 10. And here I have sorted the array because the 8 is greater than 5 and the 10 is also greater than 8. So these numbers are now in ascending order. So in this way, your insertion sort is going to work. Now let us see the concept in detail. Just see here, we have 5 cards: 1, 6, 2, 10, 3, 24, 4, 36, and 5 is 12. Now let us focus on this 12. 12 is not at appropriate place. So what will happen? We have to place 12 if you want to make the actually sorting in ascending way. Then you have to place 12 something over here, means between 10 and 24. So what you are going to do, you're going to move first 36 to 12th place, 24 to 36th place, and then you can shift 12 to 24th place. Just see here, I have moved 36, I have moved 24, and here I have arranged the place for 12 and I can set 12 over here. So in this way, your insertion sort is going to work. Okay, let us understand more deeply. This is the algorithm. This is the actual working. Okay, now just see here. This is your input array. 5, so A1 is equal to 5, A2 is equal to 2, A3 is equal to 4, A4 is equal to 6, A5 is equal to 1, and A6 is equal to 3. So these are 6 numbers, and we want to sort those numbers. Before sorting that particular number, we have to divide our array in 2 groups. The one is the left subarray, whereas the second one is the right subarray. The left subarray is always sorted array, and the right subarray is always unsorted array, or the array which we have to study. This is the simple concept that we are going to work. So let us start here. The first number, it's constant, and we are going to vary from 2nd, 3rd, 4th, fifth and sixth. So we treat the left subarray as sorted and the right subarray as not sorted, or the array which we want to study. So now we will treat this as a sorted. I will color it into the green, and this one is unsorted. I will color it into the red. Now you want to sort the unsorted array, so you want to compare the sorted region with the unsorted regions, or the region which is not sorted. So how it will go, just see here, this is 5 will be compared with 2. Now if you want to work with some ascending order, so 2 will occupy the position of 5 and 5 will occupy the position of 2, and your pointer will forwarded by one character, or pointer will forwarded by one location. Okay, just see here, as we are going to deal with some we are going to sort the array in ascending manner, so your pointer at 5 will be compared with pointer at 2, and 2 will be replaced by 5, and 5 will be replaced by 2, as well as your pointer will be forwarded by one position. So here now we have 2 and 5 which is sorted, and we have 4, 6, 1, 3 as an unsorted. So this is the left and this is your right. Now again you have to focus the sorted element to unsorted element. So if you focus on 2 and 2 with 4, 2 is less than 4, so no problem. But if you focus the 5 with 4, what will happen? The 5 is greater than 4, so 5 will replace the position of 4, and 4 will be replaced the position of 5. So here 4 will be replaced, 4 will replace position of 5, and 5 will replace the position of 4, and the pointer will be forwarded by one point or one character. So now this is your sorted array and this is unsorted array, and this is your left subarray and this is your right subarray. Now your this sorted contain will be compared with unsorted contain. 2 is less than 4, no problem. 4 is less than 6, no problem. 5 is less than 6, yes, again no problem. So we are not going to shift any position, but we are going to shift the pointer by 1. So now this is unsorted as well as this is the sorted. This is the left and this is your right. Now again just check here, 2 is compared with 1. Okay, as 2 is compared with 1, 2 is not less than 1, so 1 will come into the position of 2. So here 1 is going to be on position of 2, but 2 is not going to occupy the position of 1. Instead of 2 will occupy the position of 4, 4 will occupy the position of 5, and 5 will occupy the position of 6. I repeat, as 2 is less than 1, 2 is not less than 1, so 1 will be replaced, 1 will replace 2, but 2 will not replace 1. Instead of that, 2 will replace 4, 4 will replace 5, and 5 will replace 6. And pointer will be forwarded by one more point. So this is your sorted and this is your unsorted. So this is your left content, this is your right content. Now let us do one more thing. 1 is compared with 3, 2 is compared with 3. It is okay, but when you are comparing 4 with 3, the 4 is not less than 3. So what will happen? 3 will take the position of 4, and 4 will take the position of 5, and 5 will take the position of 6. Okay, again 4 will take the position of 5, and 5 will take the position of 6, and pointer will be forwarded by one character, and this is the last one. So now this is all your sorted array. this is all your sorted array. So any query? Okay, now this is the algorithm that we are going to study. So just see here, I will read for j is equal to 2 to n. If the key belongs to a of j, then while I is greater than 0 and while a of I is greater than key, what will happen? Do a of I plus 1 to a of I, and I will be I minus 1, and a of I plus 1 is equal to key. Now after reading that, you will not understood anything, so let me explain thoroughly so you will get the understanding. Just see here, we have 8 numbers. Okay, a1, a2, a3, a4, a5, a6, a7, a8. Now my loop will run from second number, because the first number is always, I'm going to treat the first number as a sorted number. So loop will run from 2 to 8. Okay, now the keyth element will be a of j, that is a of 2. So the key element will be a2. So the key element will be a2. Now what I will do, if it is if I want to insert that number, then I will insert that number. If I don't want to insert that number, I will just forward that particular number. Okay, now how this will work? Suppose if I want to insert this a5, suppose we have come over here and I want to insert a5 somewhere here. Okay, so what, or somewhere here, what I will do, I will replace a3 by a5. So it will be like this, a1, a2, and a5. And then every I position is shifted to I plus 1. I repeat, every I position is shifted to I plus 1. Means now, as we have a5 over here, now there should be, I want to set a3 somewhere. Now a3 is at third position. So I is equal to 3. So I plus 1 will be 4. So now a3 will move to fourth position just because of this line. Again, a4 is at fourth position, and because of I plus 1, a4 will move to fifth position, and so on. Okay. So in this way, you are going to work with insertion sort. So this is all about your insertion sort, working of insertion sort. Okay, so let us have some question answer session.